Hi you guys, good morning. Welcome back to another vlog. Today is Saturday. I thought we'd do a little weekend vlog. I feel like I never film on the weekends anymore. It's just like weekly. So I thought we would dedicate this vlog to the weekend because we kind of have a lot going on this weekend. Dylan and I are driving home tonight because I have a bridal shower tomorrow that's in Georgia and he's gonna drive me. So we're gonna go tonight. So that'll be tomorrow. But this morning I'm heading to spring practice. They have spring ball currently going on for Dylan's work. So I'm gonna go meet some of the other gals there and watch spring practice. I just got dressed and ready. I'm trying to leave a little bit early because I really want to go get a Starbucks matcha. I'm like obsessed with the drink. It's the iced lavender oat milk matcha latte, but I get it with whole milk. It's so good. It has me in like a chokehold right now. I need to stop going, but I'm like, you know, it's the weekend. I'm gonna treat myself. So I just got dressed in this little Lululemon outfit. I've worn this jacket in a vlog before and I saw a lot of questions in the comments about it. So I wanted to do a quick little spring leading into summer Lululemon haul. They have so many good pieces right now on their website. And I honestly needed to size up in a few things with the growing body. So I wanted to show you guys a few new selects that I made from Lululemon, and I wanted to thank them for sponsoring today's video. Always a dream come true to work with Lululemon. They're literally my favorite brand. I wear them every single day, at least something on my body at all times is Lululemon. I'm looking in the viewfinder at myself and I got a spray tan yesterday and I just rinsed it off, but I feel like I didn't rinse my face off enough. And then I also have some pregnancy melasma like starting underneath my eyes. So it always makes my conceal, like it makes me look like I have white circles around my eyes. So I feel like a little crazy. So let's just ignore that. I needed to maybe wash my face a little bit better, but anyways, I wanted to give you guys a little haul. I will link all the products that I talk about below for you guys. And I will also put the sizes and stuff. Normally pre-pregnancy body, I was around a 4 to a 6 in sizing. I've gone up to a size 8 in bottoms. And then for tops, I normally am like a 6 or an 8 in this t-shirt. I'm wearing a 10 because I wanted it oversized, but this is the All Yours cotton tee, obsessed with this shirt. I wear it all the time. I have like so many colors. I sized up to a 10 for the belly, but pre-pregnancy I was like a 6. So I just wanted to touch on the sizing in case you're new to Lululemon. If you've never bought from Lululemon before, what are you doing? They're literally the best. I feel like their quality is unmatched and it really is some of the stuff that I keep in my wardrobe time and time again. I was actually going through my workout drawer to clean it out while we were moving because I moved all of it into the dresser, and literally the only sports bra brand that I kept was all just Lululemon because they literally are the best. And like, I cannot wait till pregnancy is over and I can get back into the gym, Pilates, all that kind of stuff, and start wearing all of my Lululemon stuff again. But until then, I have some new pieces that are fitting the pregnancy body, and I have a few selects for Dylan as well. I feel like I get some questions sometimes about where I get his clothes. So I can start with this little outfit that I got him for. It was kind of like a little Easter gift. But I love Lululemon running shorts for guys. I think that they look so nice on them. And I love all the new fun colors that they come out with every year. So where's the 7-inch? Because he's obviously tall. They have different inseams though. And this is the Pace Breaker short in the linerless. He prefers the linerless. They have some that have the lining. But how cute is this color? I'm like, I want a girl style in this color. So cute. And then I paired it with this tan top. My belly's starting to get big enough to where I think I need to start wearing Dylan's shirts. I'm like, I might be snagging this, but I get him a double X in this as well. And the material of this is so nice. And what I like about these shirts is he can wear them to like work and stuff because they don't have a huge logo across the front. But also he can dress this up or dress this down. It's the soft jersey short sleeve. Lightweight jersey fabric, sweat wicking, quick drying. Love this little color combo together for him. So I picked this up as a little spring outfit. He got this in his Easter basket, but he hasn't worn it, so the tags are still on. So I just grabbed it out of the closet to show y'all because it honestly is not warmed up in Nashville yet. It's like pretty chilly. Like today I'm in pants and this jacket, which I want to show y'all. But for spring and stuff, when it gets warm, this color will be so nice. I got this pair of biker shorts in black and this like taupe brownie color, and I got the size 8, and this is the Lululemon Align high rise short in the 6-inch. I always get the longer inseam, but I wanted to do a little bit shorter, and I have them in black. They're actually in the wash. They are so good. Everyone has told me to, if you're pregnant, to get the Aligns because the fabric is so nice and such like high quality that it really does stretch with your bump. But then also after pregnancy, you can still wear them. So I got a size 8. I did size up because I don't like things tight on me. And then I figured postpartum, I'll be fine and I'll be able to wear these. I also really love Lululemon's Wonder Train material. It's just not as quite stretchy as the Align. So I'll link both. I'll link like my favorite biker shorts and leggings down below for you guys. I would definitely say my two favorite fabrics would be the Align material and then the Wonder Train. So I got these in a black and this taupe brown color. I've been wearing the black nonstop, but I did get this to go with this. I love like a monochromatic look, but like all of the colors being a slightly off. So I thought these two tans is really cute. Also picked up this ultralight waist length t-shirt. I got a size 8 and this is the softest, nicest quality. It's more of a workout material, definitely on the thinner side than say this All Yours cotton tee, but this I figured it was cropped. Some days I just want my belly out. If I'm doing like an at-home workout or something, I figured this would be good with leggings or the biker shorts, and I just loved the color. And then I thought post-pregnancy this would also be super cute and fit. It's a super lightweight and slightly sheer mesh fabric, breathable, sweat wicking, and quick drying. So I haven't had a chance to wear this yet, but I know this will be one of the shirts in my closet that I keep for years and years. I love the material of this. Let me move you guys a little bit. Okay, then we have what I'm wearing. This is kind of the last few little things I wanted to share with you guys. So this is the All Yours cotton tee. I love this tan color. Again, I was kind of going for like that monochromatic. Fits the belly. I sized up to a size 10, but I have this shirt and I've been wearing this shirt for years. I have it in like a gray, a white, a black. They just are so good over anything and everything. And I'll always like wear them to my workout and then take them off if I just want to like work out in my sports bra. It's just like a really good relaxed fit t-shirt that isn't like a hot, heavy cotton. So love this. I will link below. This one fits the bump nicely. And then over the top, I have this jacket. I saw this jacket and I was like, I have to have this. I am a jacket and a swimsuit freak. Like, jackets and swimsuits are my weakness. But this I loved because I just felt like it's a really nice, easy transition jacket, especially for Nashville. I feel like we're still experiencing those few colder days. So I just really, really love this. I definitely would say if you snag this jacket to size down, it does run super oversized. I'm on the taller side and it's still very long on me. I pictured to wear this with the biker shorts, hanging out in like sneakers. The bottom cinches in and I love an oversized jacket that covers your backside, like goes long over your bum in case you're like wearing biker shorts, something in or out of class, or if you have to like run into the grocery store. Throwing this on is so nice, so lightweight. It's very breathable. I wish you guys could feel the fabric. It's like super buttery soft. So anyways, love this jacket if you're looking for a good one to snag for spring. This is the one. You can dress it up or dress it down. There's pockets. You can obviously tighten this as it goes. I probably could have done one size smaller. I got a size medium, but super cute. For pants today, I'm wearing these Lululemon Align The Flare with the like crossed waistband. They are so comfy. Like, I literally have been living in these pants. And then I also have on a pair of Lululemon sneakers. I'll link below. I'm like fully Lululemon out. And these are so good. I love the flare. Super flattering on your leg. I sized up to an 8 in these, just like the biker shorts. And I feel like these will fit me probably for like the rest of my pregnancy. They're not digging at my waist or anything. So really love these. Last but not least, it's never a full Lululemon haul until I show you guys the white ankle socks. These are the best ankle socks ever. I always, whenever I place an order, pick up a new pack. They come in a pack of 3. They are the Power Stride training sock. I wear them under any like athletic sneaker. I just love the fit and I love like where they hit on the ankle. They're super flattering. I have them on right now today. So I get a size medium and they're literally the best socks ever. They have packs of like gray, black, they have colored ones, but I just always get the all white. I'm gonna head off to Dylan's practice, gonna go watch Dylan. I'm excited. I haven't been to a practice this spring yet, so that'll be fun. But I just wanted to quickly show you guys those new pieces that I got in from Lululemon. Again, always such a dream come true to work with them. So thank you, Lululemon, for sponsoring today's video. I will link all the pieces below. They have so many good new pieces out for spring, so many good new colors and things like that. So check them out. I will link everything below for y'all.
Come on, let's go. You want one? Here you go. Be a good girl. Are you gonna be a good or bad dog while I'm gone? Be a good dog, okay? There you go. Okay, bye.
If you missed the last vlog, this is the drink. It is so good. It's just their new lavender oat milk matcha latte, and I get it with whole milk instead of oat milk. It's 10 out of 10 every time. Back from practice. I just put together a little overnight bag before you come for me for shoes on the bed. I'm about to wash these sheets. So anyways, I got my dress. I ended up finding a dress. If you guys watched last vlog, I could not find something to wear to this bridal shower. I found this little Free People maxi spring dress at Nordstrom Rack. So
excited about that. I have like a little sweatshirt, pajamas, boxer shorts for tomorrow for the car ride home. I'm also gonna bring these Lululemon sneakers, which here's a better look at these. They are so good, you guys. I'm obsessed with them. I will link them. I love the color and I love how they look on your foot. I think that this is a newer color and style, so I will link them for you guys. They run very true to size. Craving a big bowl of fruit, so I just put a bunch of random fruits, trying to mix it up, that we had in the fridge in here, and I'm gonna make like a little sauce for it. I did this on Easter and I wanted to share because it's so good. You do lemon zest, honey, and half of a lime. If you're making like for a bigger portion, like a big bowl of it for a party or something, obviously do more. I kind of just eyeball it. You pour it over when it's ready to serve, so don't pour it over and then like let it sit for days just because it'll soften the fruit, but it is so good. I saw it on Pinterest, obsessed with it, and I've been so craving fruit this whole pregnancy, and this just makes it taste even better. I just made a little TikTok of me making the little dressing, but it's so simple. It's only those two ingredients, but if you guys want to follow me on TikTok, I've kind of been posting a little bit more over there, but it's so good. I'm gonna go sit on the couch and eat this, watch a little bit. I've been re-watching Grey's Anatomy, which is so funny. I feel like I used to be obsessed with that show. So do you want to come on the couch and watch TV? She's like, no, I just want your food.
Took a long time to know what I wanted, and now I do. And I will wait on you. It took a long time to know what I needed, and now it's clear whenever you
go ahead. Go give it to her.
No,
it's for
who?
Go give it to mom.
A long time to find what I was looking for, but when it did, it all fit together. It took a long time.
Good morning, you guys. I completely flopped on the weekend vlog, but we're back. It's Tuesday. I'm getting ready for a doctor's appointment. Today's our 33 week, and then I think I go back 2 weeks later, and that starts our every week appointment, which is so crazy. I'm feeling very, very pregnant these days. I just made a little smoothie. I know I did a terrible job at vlogging at home, but we were literally there for such a quick, short amount of time. It was kind of chaos. And then yesterday was Monday, and I sat literally at this same exact spot that I'm sitting right now when I did my taxes. I had to finish filling out like an expense sheet. So I went through and did that, and taxes should be all good to go. I have an accountant who files them for me and like does all of the hard part, but I just had to fill out my expense report sheet. I sat and did that yesterday, got everything together for that. And today we are vlogging again, finishing off this vlog for you guys. I just made a little smoothie. I made a different little recipe than the one. Did you just burp? Made a new little recipe because I was out of like my normal stuff. So we've got frozen banana, frozen mango, frozen strawberry, and then I did orange juice and the Amra, and it is so good. It tastes like a like beach drink, like a almost like a beach cocktail or something. My dad is actually coming into town either tonight or tomorrow morning. I'm not exactly sure when he's gonna get here. So that'll be fun to see him. He hasn't seen our new place, and he's just coming for like a day or two to hang out, to chill, to see us. So that'll be nice. I haven't seen my dad in a while because he didn't come home for the baby shower. So it's been a while since I've seen him. But other than that, we're kind of just like chilling today. I have some work to film and just kind of getting stuff together. The dresser for the nursery finally shipped yesterday, thank God. So it's going to be here in 2 weeks, which is like honestly cutting it close. So I can finally start doing nursery stuff and like nesting. But I do want to get like, I have all of my stuff together for like bedside caddies. I'm gonna do like a baby one and a mom one for postpartum. I actually had a postpartum station set up in the last house, which is what I thought was gonna be his nursery, and we ended up moving, so I disassembled it. And then I realized I think I'm just gonna do a large caddy. I follow her name's Lauren. She's one of the co-founders of Summer Friday. She just had a baby boy. She has 3 kids, and she posts the best baby links. And she posted how she does like a caddy for the baby and a caddy for her, so she can just like bring it all around the house and set it wherever she needs to set it at points. And I was like, wait, that's kind of smart, instead of having something that has to stay in a room. So I think I'm gonna do caddies. I ordered two off of Amazon. I don't know if that's gonna be in this video, but I'm just kind of like speaking out loud. But yeah, anyways, I was texting my friend Sydney this morning, which was nice. She always, if you guys know Sydney Tillman, I actually brought her to Portugal for the Dolce Vita trip. And it's so crazy because she was actually the first one that found out I was pregnant, because I literally found out that day when I met her at the airport. I was like, I have to tell someone. So she's known since like 4 weeks that I've been pregnant. And she's been so sweet and kind, always checking in on me. And I text her this morning back after. She was like, hi, how are you doing? She always will text me like early in the morning. If you guys don't follow her, she's the sweetest. It's Sid Till on Instagram. We've known each other since we were like 5 years old, which is also so crazy. But our families are close friends, so we've like known each other and grown up together. But she always texts me and checks in, and I was like, I text back, I'm like, you know what, thank you so much for always checking in on me. I feel like, which is something I did not know or think that I would feel like, but I feel like pregnancy, especially towards the end, maybe I'm starting to feel this way, it can be so lonely. And I don't know if it's because of social media these days, you see everyone doing all these things and Coachella's this weekend and like all that kind of stuff. Obviously I can't like attend and do that kind of stuff this year as much as I would want to. I'm like preparing for a new life and a whole new like chapter, and I would not change it for the world. I'm so excited for this chapter of mine and Dylan's life, but it's just like a new something that I'm getting used to, and it's hard because like the baby's not here yet, so it's like I'm just kind of here alone. And I didn't realize how like lonely pregnancy can be, and I feel like I've heard women talk about it, but until you go through it, you don't really realize. So I like was like, thank you so much for always checking in, it's so sweet. If you have a friend who is pregnant, maybe send them a check in and like, how are you doing type of message, because it does get pretty lonely towards the end. It's kind of like the last few weeks are drug out and long. So anyways, I'm hoping the baby stays all nice and cozy as much as I want him to be here. I am not prepared for him to be here yet. We have a few things that we're still waiting on to get here. Like the car seat's not even here yet. Just having a little chat with you guys this morning. It's so funny because I kept putting things off, and I think it's because I always knew I wanted to move out of that house. So I wasn't like ordering anything because I figured we'll have to just like move it over to a new place. And we're waiting to see if we were moving for Dylan's job or what was gonna be the situation for that. But I kept telling myself like, no, you can't order the stroller yet. Like it's way too early. No, you can't order the car seat. It's way too early. Order the stuff early if you are early on in your pregnancy, because once it gets to the end, things are sold out. Things take a while to get in, and you don't want to be like without something. Like if he came right now, we would not have a car seat. We have the doula, which is fine, but I did hear that some people say that sometimes hospitals don't approve that for the going home car seat. I don't know if that's true or not, but I ended up getting a Nuna Pippa Air, I believe that's what it's called. I just ordered it. It should be here like today or tomorrow. So we're gonna get that installed in my car, and then we'll have the doula just to go back and forth between Dylan's car and mine, and then also like my mom's car when she takes care of him or whoever is like watching him or something like that. So I wanted to have like a car seat that attached to his stroller. So we got the Nuna. The stroller we got is by the brand Silvercross, but there's like attachments that you can put into the car seat. It's like this whole thing. All this stuff sounds crazy. I feel like when I first started out being pregnant or just got pregnant, I was like, wait, I feel so overwhelmed with baby stuff. But once you like do your research and stuff, you kind of like get to know the brands and what's good and not. But anyways, I'm excited to show you guys all that stuff, but literally nothing has come in except the doula. So if he were to be born right now, I mean, I am early, so he would probably have to stay at the hospital for a little, but we would have the doula at least. So we're still just waiting on the stroller, the dresser, the car seat, and then I think that's really it. We have mostly everything else. So anyways, good morning. I just wanted to do a little chat with you guys. I'm gonna drink this smoothie on the way to the doctor. Dylan sadly can't make it to this appointment. I think it's only the second one that he's not been to. He missed one early on, and then he's missing today because they're in spring ball and it falls right when practice started. And he was like, I can get out of it if you want me to be there. And I know he wants to be there. He feels so bad when he misses them because he's already texted me like a million times. But I feel like the appointments are so quick. It's not a major appointment today. Like, there's nothing really going on. It's really just to check the heartbeat and then to see what I'm measuring at. They literally take 5 seconds and they're like, all right, any questions? And then you literally leave. So it's nothing crazy. It's not like we're seeing the baby today, like no ultrasound or anything like that. But I do want to book a 3D ultrasound. I found a place here and I need to call because they were closed Sunday, Monday. So I do need to call today and book that because I've been wanting to see a little 3D. We haven't seen an ultrasound of him since he was 20 weeks. And now I'm 30, I'll be 33 Friday. And I'm like, I need to see what he looks like. I'm so excited. So I want to do a little 3D ultrasound. They have like a bunch of little ultrasound boutique type of things here. It's like $80 to go in and see a little 3D ultrasound. So we're going to book that. And I'm going to book it around Dylan's schedule so he can definitely be there for that one.
I came to Costco right after the doctor just because it's early. And I'm like, Costco early in the morning is such a move. There's literally no one here. So I'm going to stock up on some groceries. Been obsessed with cuties, bananas, cucumber, stocking up. I've never been to Costco this early. It's so enjoyable. There's like not a million people everywhere. I'm out of breath from loading up my car. I ended up going to Costco after the doctor. Everything went well at the doctor. Measuring on time, my blood pressure's still looking good. His heart rate sounds good, so that is all good to go, which is always nice to hear. And then I came to Costco. It was such a relaxing experience. There was like barely anyone in here. It opened, and I got here like 3 minutes after it opened. I'm like all out of breath. It is raining today, so that kind of blows, but got the car loaded up. I feel like you can really tell in this lighting, my melasma, I think that's what it's called, is really kicking in these last few weeks of pregnancy. I heard it's called like pregnancy mask. Like a lot of women get it towards the end and then apparently it goes away after you're done being pregnant. But it looks like I almost got like sunburn underneath my eyes. It looks like I have white raccoon eyes. So it's kind of crazy. I don't have any makeup on right now, but I'm just using like gentle skincare because there really isn't anything that you can do while being pregnant to treat melasma. Like there's no pregnancy skincare that is safe. I've just been using Tatcha Harper cleanser, Face Reality, like my normals. And I don't think it's any of the products I'm using. I think it's just the pregnancy. So that's kind of what's going on with the skin. It just reminded me because it looks very, I feel like it looks very aggressive in this lighting, but we're gonna go home, unload the car. I can give you guys a little Costco haul, but it's really nothing like that exciting. Just need to stock up on some like fruit, berries, other things. I got some chicken breast. I got a rotisserie chicken for dinner tonight. Just random things like that. So we're gonna head home. I went to our downstairs closet to get a raincoat this morning and it makes me laugh. The only raincoat I have is this Georgia one. Like I need to get a non-college raincoat. I feel like that's something I just like forget about to get. Everything is out of the car. Quick little Costco haul. I don't want to bore you guys because a lot of this is just like plain stuff, but I got a thing of cuties. I already ate one in the car on the way home. They're so good right now. I think they're in season. They're so yummy. Avocados, a bunch of chicken breast, wild frozen blueberries. I put these in my smoothies like every morning, so I decided to just get a big bag of those. Rotisserie chicken, cucumbers, banana. I got Dylan this pack of underwear, but I don't think it's gonna fit him because I think he needs an XL and they didn't have any, but I figured I would try. Toothpaste, spinach. I got cranberry juice. They didn't have pineapple juice, but I'm gonna start doing the raspberry leaf tea like next week. If you guys did that when you were pregnant and you made like the cranberry pineapple with raspberry leaf tea over ice, let me know if your labor was easier than normal, I guess. I also got a thing of dates to start doing dates in my smoothies. Apparently this is another thing that can help labor go a little bit quicker. So if you did the dates or the tea, let me know your thoughts or opinions or when you started it, how much you did, how little you did, anything like that. Cheese platter. These are the best crackers. I always get them at Publix, but they're so much cheaper at Costco. Bag of Doritos for Dylan. I always pick up dog toys at Costco because they're pretty good quality and Winnie is like queen of tearing through toys and they're always pretty affordable. Got some salted butter. This brand of butter is so yummy. Applewood smoked bacon and then some berries. And then I got this little thing of flowers. I thought these were so pretty for spring for the house. My dad comes tonight. He just called. So I want to make sure that the house is all nice and cute when he gets here because he hasn't seen the new place. So I'm gonna put all of this stuff away. Rolling hamper from Amazon is like the best thing that I've ever bought because we have this long hallway. So just rolling laundry. I'm gonna do a few loads of wash. I wanted to share this though because I got sent these and they are so good. I have these candles. It's from the brand Sniff, S-N-I-F. This is the laundry detergent. In sweet ash, and then I also have in rain check. They smell so good. This is the like scent booster. I pour just like a tiny bit
into the laundry. Instead of using these beads, I now use this little scent booster, and it smells incredible, and it lingers onto your clothes and your sheets and stuff, so it like holds the scent, and I love it. So I just thought I would share. Their candles are really good too. The brand is Sniff. Laundry is just one of those things that is literally never ending. Having this laundry room though has been so nice compared to the last place when we just had that closet. Like, it's so nice to have a room in here. Sorry, my phone keeps going off and you guys are propped up on it. So a few hours later, since I vlogged, I have just been doing some work. I had to do some editing and some like edits for a few brands, submit that, and then my dad's on his way, so I'm trying to get the house picked up a little bit. I need to get his room like all ready to go with like towels and stuff. I'm gonna throw a load of laundry in. So that's kind of what is up. Just a chill day over here, like work and the doctor and stuff, which we already did. We're supposed to have a few rainy days in Nashville. The temperature's kind of dropping again, which is like the weather. It's been so weird. I put on this sweat scent because I was kind of chilly in the house. Get my dad's room ready and then finish up work for the day. It's only around like 3 o'clock, so we're kind of doing good with timing. I just went up to the nursery and I grabbed all of the bottles that we got from the baby shower. A few of these were left over from my sister. Carson never ended up taking a bottle because he was in the NICU, so he never had a bottle, which is the craziest thing because he had the feeding tube. So I have some of Sarah's leftover bottles that she got from her baby shower, and then I also got a bottle box. This is a really cool thing they do on Babylist. It's like a bottle subscription, and it comes with like a bunch of different types of bottles. Just because it's hard, you don't know what kind of bottle your baby's gonna want to take. So here's like five, I guess, of the most popular. And then we got this sterilizer all set up. So it's a washer, sterilizer, dries it all type of thing. And you can also put like passies and stuff in there. So I'm gonna do that next. I think this is probably gonna take like 2 rounds because I have a good bit of bottles. But I'm gonna get all of these washed and sanitized, and then cabinet right here for all the bottles and stuff like that to go, which is so crazy to start having baby stuff up in our kitchen cabinets. It's so exciting. That being said, I'm gonna take all of these out of here and get this knocked off of my to-do list. I mean, this is like the tiniest little thing ever. I've heard good things about the Dr. Browns. The two little boys I used to nanny, actually, I think used these Dr. Brown ones. I've also seen and heard good things about, I want to say it's this one, but I'm not exactly sure. I know every baby is different. Obviously, once we figure out what kind of bottle he wants to take, we will buy more of that kind. But I think it's cool to be able to try out a bunch of different ones. I feel like that's with a lot of baby stuff. Like with passies, there's so many different kinds. With swaddles, there's so many different kinds. You kind of just got to figure out what they like, which is the hard part because baby stuff is not cheap. I also brought this down. It was on my registry. It is a little bottle drying rack for on the go whenever we don't have this sterilizer with us. I figured when we go to the beach and stuff, this will be nice to bring to my mom's or really anywhere. It's like a little compact little travel thing. So I'm gonna put this in the pantry. You guys, there's so many parts to a baby bottle. Like, I don't even know how it works. I know all these parts come off, but like, am I even doing this right? I know I've watched a few videos where it's like, people say they stack the stuff in here to get more bottles out of their wash. So I guess we'll see. I'm already messing up. Okay, I'm gonna do all the Dr. Brown ones first.
We got it working. I could not figure out why I wouldn't turn on. It's because I needed to reset this outlet. So it's all good to go. We've got the first cycle going. Forever holding out for you. Took a long